next on AM 1480 WLEA, the Newsmaker Show. Here's Ryan O'Neill.
Well, thank you for coming into the studio. Alive this morning, Hornell Mayor John Buckley.
Hey, Brian. Good morning. Thanks for having me on.
Well, we just had in our newscast that Hornell Police Officer Ian Hamilton just finished up at the Corning Community College Southern Tier Law Enforcement Academy.
Yeah, Ian Hamilton, young officer we hired about a year or so ago, and just a very, very nice young man. We're so excited to have him on board. Our police department has a lot of young officers these days, and a lot of young and up and coming, very good, on the road right out of the school there, Brian. He's done such a wonderful job, really integrating himself with the community, community policing. You see him at different events down at the Fall Fest. He was down there walking around. And that's what I like to see, especially out of the young officers, is, going that extra mile and getting to know the public. It's one thing to drive around in the police car and do patrols. That's another thing to, really, try to meet the people in the community and get to know them on a more personal level. And that's what I've been seeing out of Officer Hamilton. So he's very, very impressive young man. I remember when we did the interviews along with the commissioners of the Board of Public Safety. And for such a young man, and I believe he was at the time the youngest officer that we've ever hired, and just really showed a maturity level beyond his years, and really wowed us. And we're so happy to have him on board, and he's going to be a tremendous asset to the police department in the city of Hornell for a lot of years to come.
The Maple City Fall Festival, that was an enormous success. I couldn't believe the numbers of people that I saw there just for a first-year event.
Yeah, I mean, I was blown away by the amount of people that showed up and participated, and everyone is having a good time. And, the thing kicked off at noon, Brian, and right at noon, there was, a mob on Main Street. There was, a lot of children and the families and, moms and dads, aunts and uncles. We had a lot of vendors. Of course, we had the car show, which was a hit. And lots of crafts and activities for the kids to do. Further on down on the City Hall end of Main Street, we had the live stage for all the different bands.
Yeah, I was driving by, 10 o'clock, I think, on Saturday night, and the streets were still packed.
Yeah, well, the bands went through the day. They started in the afternoon and went through the night. And, and what a nice turnout. And, we kind of had a setup where we had on the Pizza King end of Main Street, we had more, crafts and arts and things for the children. And then, more adult oriented as you got down to the other side. And of course the car show in between. So much food and so much fun.
A lot of positive comments on Facebook.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And of course we, we put up the lights on Main Street, the decorative lights, and which really just gives Main Street a nice effect, and that seems to be very popular. And we decided we're going to keep those lights up straight through the holidays, so we're very excited to do that. But yeah, just overall, even at the midway point, just the amount of people and the traffic that was coming and going, the foot traffic, totally exceeded my expectations. And you never know what to expect when you put something like this together. And just to give you a little bit of background, about a year ago, I was thinking, I want to do something on Main Street, have something maybe in August. I was thinking maybe have like a music festival and, have a car show as a part of it. And then I got talking to Michelle Pogue, who's a chairwoman of Hornell Partners for Growth, and she had some ideas of a fall festival. And so basically what we did was we merged our two ideas and just combined everything. And Saturday was the result of that. And what a smashing success. I was talking to some folks at the car show after we did the awards presentation, and I don't recall where they were from, but they drove I think an hour and a half to 2 hours to get here just to participate in the car show. And the young man had won a trophy, And his mother came over and said, "Wow, this is such a wonderful festival. How long have you been doing this?" And I said, "This is our first year." She looked at me and she says, "Get out of here. This can't be the first time." I was like, "No, really, this is the first year."
No, the crowds were like a macker event.
Yes, yeah, and you're exactly right. And it drew a lot of people from neighboring communities and you know, in some cases even hours away just to come. And you know, I think if this is a sign of things to come, then we're going to have a very successful festival for many, many, many years, and we'll do it again next year. And you know, as long as I'm the mayor, Brian, we'll keep the fall festival going. But why not have a fall festival in Hornell? We are the Maple City, after all, so it makes complete sense to have a fall festival right here in Hornell, New York.
And the trees are so nice this time of year. And coming, it'll be in about 2 weeks. Driving up the hill or driving around the area, the trees are just it's just a beautiful view.
Yeah, the leaves are, you know, they're slowly starting to turn. And of course, you know, we live in such a gorgeous area. You know, you go for a drive this time of year, and you know, as you get into October with all the colorful hillsides and all the beauty, and I think that's something we take for granted, you know, just living here and having that as a backdrop. You know, just even right here in Hornell in the valley, just taking a look at up in the hills. You know, as we get into the fall months and just the foliage, it's really gorgeous. You know, we're very fortunate to live where we do, and we have a lot to be thankful for. So, but yeah, you know, again, successful fall festival, and we'll take the momentum from this and ride it right into the Christmas season, and we'll have a huge Christmas event again this year, and even that event last year, Brian, was a huge success. And you know, we had I don't even know how many people we had on Main Street last year for the Christmas event, but it was a packed house around the Christmas tree for Santa Claus. And I think this year is going to be even bigger, if you can imagine that.
Talking live in the studio this morning with Hornell Mayor John Buckley. Well, I think everybody pretty much knows, if they've had a doctor's appointment in the last 6 or 8 months, that things are moving up to the old Kmart Plaza, what they call the medical office building there, for the new St. James. Have you been inside the hospital area yet?
Yeah, actually, a couple weeks ago, I took a tour of the new facility along with some other people from City Hall. And we got together and met Brian O'Donovan, the CEO for St. James up there, and he gave us a tour of the new building. And you know, there's still a lot of work to do, a lot of finishing touches. They're running you know, the conduit and the electric and the plumbing and the ductwork and all that, but the building itself is very impressive. And actually, you know, once you're inside it, it's a lot larger than you would think. You know, driving by it on the road, you think, well, okay, it's, you know, maybe a smaller footprint, doesn't look that big. But I tell you what, once you're inside there, you know, you can get lost very easily and kind of spun around. But it's you know, a lot of time and effort went into the design and the layout of the new facility, and I think they're really maximizing every inch and every foot of the new facility. And it's definitely going to have a nice flow to it, especially as far as the emergency department goes, where the ambulances will drop off the patients and bring them in. And I think it'll be a lot easier to you know, get them to where they need to be as far as just the layout goes. But you know, so excited! You know, what a great thing for our community. And it wasn't all that long ago, Brian, you know, we were on the brink of not having healthcare here in Hornell or the Canisteo Valley. You know, we were day to day, didn't know if the doors were going to be locked when you woke up the next morning. And you know, to go from where we were to where we are is very impressive. And you know, what a community effort, unlike none that I've ever seen before. But you know, the months are going by quickly, and I think, you know, we're looking at March as far as the grand opening of the new facility, and that dovetails nicely with the medical village, which is already up and running. And you know, we've got you know, lots of doctors and offices up there, and people are already going up for appointments. So that's going to be you know, just one heck of a state of the art facility when it's all said and done. And also, you know, one thing that people don't necessarily think of, I think it's going to be a great recruitment tool for, you know, those young healthcare professionals that you want to attract to your community. Because, you know, when you're trying to attract young healthcare professionals, you know, doctors, nurses, technicians, or you know, whoever it may be, you know, when you have that old facility that, you know, it's kind of run down and dilapidated in some cases, not efficient at all. But then all of a sudden you have this brand new facility, and, you know, that in itself is a great recruitment tool. And folks, other than Corning a couple years back in Hornell, there's not a lot of new hospitals being built in the Northeast. There really aren't. So, you know, we need to count our lucky stars that we have this, and we'll have it for a long time in the future. And of course, where they are, they have plenty of room to expand if need be. So, you know, the first thing is get the doors open, you know, get the patients in there, deliver a high quality product, high level of service, and then grow it from there. And I think that's what Brian O'Donovan's focused on, and that's what I'm focused on. So we're very, very, very proud and very happy to have him come on board.
Talking about St. James with Hornell Mayor John Buckley this morning, moving on to another major employer, that being Alstom. The lieutenant governor was at Alstom within the last couple of weeks. Wondering, did you have a chance to meet her? Were you over there for that event?
Well, I was actually at NICOM, at a NICOM conference,
that's right.
Which is NICOM stands for the New York Conference of Mayors. And the lieutenant governor had called my office, and literally the day before. So, yeah, it wasn't exactly great timing. I was 4 hours away at the conference, so I couldn't drive down the street to meet her. But, you know, that was very nice that the lieutenant governor took the time out to tour the Alstom facilities. And the lieutenant governor and I, we've spent some time together over the last few years, and I've actually toured Alstom with her in the past. But it's nice that, you know, she takes the time to come down, and you know, especially the state has a $30 million investment in Alstom as well. So it's nice for her to, you know, kind of check up on their progress and to see how they're doing. And, you know, and it's always good, at least in my estimation, it's always good when you have, you know, a governor or a lieutenant governor or your congressman or your state senator or come down to Alstom and really kind of, you know, put the spotlight, shine that spotlight on Alstom, because they are such an important part of our community and you know, not just the city itself, but really in the entire region, just because of how many people they employ and the products that they deliver. And you know, so, you know, all arrows are pointing upwards, and Alstom keeps chugging along. They're right around 800 employees strong. Working on that Excel line only, you know, and I keep harping on it, but Hornell, New York is the only place in the country where that high-speed rail is being manufactured right here in our own backyard. So that's a pretty cool thing.
I just saw on a Hornell resident's Facebook page, and this is somebody that's down in Washington, D.C., who said he was on a subway recently in Washington and saw the Made in Hornell Alstom sign. So, you know, we always think of those cars being made for New York City, but apparently I didn't know this, that some of the subway cars in D.C. too.
Yeah, well, Alstom, you know, they've serviced subway cars from a wide range of places around the country, you know, Boston and obviously D.C. So it's not uncommon, and I've seen the same thing over the years, where you know, when people are from Hornell or out of town, and they're taking the metro or wherever they may be, and they see that nameplate, they'll take a picture of it and post it up on their Facebook page. And, you know, and that's a nice, that's a good thing to be proud about. And, you know, when you're out traveling and you're on a rail car and you see that, you know, little placard that says Made in Hornell, I mean, that's a pretty neat thing. And, you know, not too many people, you know, can look up at something like that wherever they are and say, "Wow, that was made in my town or my city or my village." You know, so that's a really neat thing to see.
Okay, we're going to take a quick break. We've got a conversation going with Hornell Mayor John Buckley. Stay with us on the Newsmaker Show here on AM 1480 WLEA.
The holidays will be here in no time, so now is the time to get that new floor installed before the guests arrive. At Mullen Factory Direct Floor Covering in Almond, they stock over 400,000 square feet of flooring. If you need carpet, vinyl, laminate, or hardwood, Mullen's got it. Quality and durable floor coverings. And your new floor can be installed by their professionals right now with no box store wait. Special financing, including 0% interest, is available too. Mullen Factory Direct Floor Covering in Almond. Stop by and let them floor you.
Checking in now with meteorologist Gary Bass. Good morning, Gary. How's it look for today?
Well, it looks kind of cloudy out there right now. We've got some scattered showers occurring. This morning's sunrise was at 7:07, Brian. It'll set tonight at 6:55 p.m. We may see some partial sun after the morning showers during this afternoon, with high temperatures reaching the mid to upper 60s, so kind of cool. Tonight, mostly cloudy, a few showers, maybe a thunder shower as well, near 60 overnight. Then it turns warm and a bit more humid on Tuesday, partly sunny, a few afternoon showers and thunderstorms on Tuesday, near 80 then, back in the 60s at night. And mostly cloudy with scattered showers and maybe a thunderstorm again on Wednesday. Beginning to cool off, though, highs around 75 and much cooler weather likely for the end of the week, Brian.
Thank you, Gary Bass, back with Hornell Mayor John Buckley. Well, Mr. Mayor, you've got the November elections coming up. How about the list of candidates on the GOP side?
Yeah, well, we have a very strong strong slate this year, starting off with Paul Van Castle, who's running for county legislature, and Paul will be running on the Republican line, the conservative line, and the independence line. And, you know, Paul has got a lot of energy, a lot of great ideas. I know he wants to be a voice for Hornell, an advocate for Hornell, and that's what we need at the county level. We really need, you know, someone that we can, especially as a mayor, as a council, someone that we can partner with and be that voice on the county level, because, you know, a lot that goes on at the county level goes unnoticed. You don't really hear too much, if anything at all, from you know, the county legislator level of elected officials, but there is an important role there to play. And, you know, I'm in constant contact with county officials, and it'd really be nice to have a Paul Van Castle type, someone who's not shy, who's going to stand up for Hornell and fight for what's best for us here in the Maple City. So, you know, I think Paul will do a great job. So, you know, he's out there.
You just had a rally with Paul and the others there over at the new GOP headquarters.
Yes, we had a packed house last week, last Thursday night. You know, Paul Van Castle was there, and is Molly Liberto, who's running in the third ward for the city council. She was on hand. Kevin Valentine, who's a newcomer, he was on hand. He's running for the seat in the seventh ward. And, of course, Alderman Steve Schinnebarger, who's running for re-election, and over in the ninth ward, my old spot. So, you know, Steve Schinnebarger, again, you know, I can't say enough about Steve Schinnebarger. He is a tremendous asset to the city common council. Does an amazing job, very constituent-minded. You know, I kind of like to compare him to Jim Bassage. You know, those two are so constituent-minded, so thoughtful, so much input, and they add so much value to the council. So it's you know, we're trying to get Steve reelected, and hopefully the, you know, the folks will, you know, realize he's been doing a good job and send him back for another 2 years. But we also have some other candidates as well. You know, Jessica Cleveland over in the sixth ward, who is an alderwoman and a deputy mayor. She's running unopposed. Jim Bassage, who I had mentioned, is running unopposed. So, you know, we've got some great candidates. Dan Warner over in the fifth ward running unopposed. But, you know, we've got three races on the council, and then, of course, the county legislator race. So it's a local year. There's not anything going on the state or federal side of things. But, you know, some people like to refer to this as an off-year election. But I can promise you, for the candidates themselves, there's no such thing as an off-year, because this is you know, their time to shine. So
sure.
But, yeah,
you know, so many people have a jaundiced view of politics, which I understand. But politicians at every level, from local to federal, have to spend so much time at work. I mean, it's just
it's a lot of work to be a politician, and it's a lot of family time you miss, I'm guessing.
Well, you use the word politician, but I like to use public servant. And that's really how I look at it. I look at it as public service. And I know most of the people on the council look at it the same way. And unfortunately, you have to go through the political, the political games and have to put up with all that. And there's a lot of nonsense, even at the local level. And unfortunately, because things are so polarized at the federal and even the state levels, that trickles down and that bleeds, that can bleed into local elections as well, when it shouldn't, because, all the nonsense that you see and hear when you turn on the national news, when you turn on Fox or CNN or MSNBC or whatever newscast you're watching, all that stuff has no effect on what we're doing at the city level. You've covered common council meetings. What are we discussing at the common council meetings? We're not discussing abortion. We're not talking about gun rights. We're not talking about the border. We're not talking about all these hot button issues. We're talking about how to improve Hornell. What can we do at James Street Park to improve that? How can we replace this road? How can we replace this bridge? What can we do? Let's do a fall festival. Let's make the Christmas event bigger. These are the things that I worry about and the things that I work on. Trying to access funding for the wastewater plant or to keep relining the sewer lines. These are all the things that we talk about and as mayor that I work on a day-to-day basis. So it's unfortunate that the country on the national level has really devolved into what it is now, but at the local level, we shouldn't let all that outside noise affect what we're doing.
Down to 60 seconds, Mayor Buckley. Do we have time to talk the residency law quickly?
Yeah, well, we can touch on it real quickly. That's one thing that's really kind of been hamstringing us in the sense of, it's been difficult to hire people, especially women. We lost our only female officer earlier in the year, and because of the residency law, we were not able to find another one. There was only 4 female officers available on the list. Couldn't reach any of them. 2 of them got scooped up by the sheriff's department. The other 2 didn't want to live here. So, this is something we could talk about in another show at another time. But, times are changing. I think it was a good law for a long time. But, you either change with the times or you fall behind. And as mayor, we can't let the city fall behind. We got to keep moving forward.
With that, we do have to go to make room for Rush and Sean here in their morning updates. Mayor Buckley, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Brian. It's always fun to be here.
Folks, get this. You won't believe this, but it did happen. Free.